Church said amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Amen. Today, from the scripture that was read, we want to talk to you about He alive. He is alive. What impossible with men is possible with God.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And I want to talk about He's alive today.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen. This epistle that was read from 1 Corinthians 15. Amen. Is known as the corrective epistle. Amen. And that Paul had to correct problems that the Corinthians had. Amen. They had much problems in their churches. And Paul had to correct these problems. Amen. They had all kinds of problems. Huh? They had all kinds of problems. Amen. The flesh, carnality. Amen. Led to divisions in the church. And they had, amen, all kind of division, and they had all kind of mixed up belief, amen, and doctrine that they believed. So it's called corrective, amen, epistle, because Paul had to correct a lot of things that were going on in the Corinthian church. Amen, and I come this morning to tell you that we have a lot of problems in our churches.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. We have division in our churches.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. We have disagreement, and sometimes, amen, we can't work it out.
That's right.
Amen. God wants us to work it out.
Yes.
He loves us. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And they had a real misunderstanding of the spiritual gifts. And Paul would tell them, if you want to look at it with me in 1 Corinthians 13, flip back a couple of pages. Amen. He said, let me show you a more excellent way. This is what he said to them. Though I speak with tongues of men and of angels, and have not love.
Yeah, all right.
I have become a sounding brass and a clanking cymbal. In other words, I can be just as good or better than the angels. But if I don't have no love,
yes, my Lord,
it's zero.
Yes.
It means nothing.
That's right.
Then it say, and though I have the gift of prophecy, and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove the mountain, but if I don't have love, it's zero.
Yeah.
All right,
all right.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You can do all those things, but if you don't have love,
All right now.
He said it means nothing.
Yes.
And then in verse 3, he said, and though I bestow all my good to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, amen, but have not love,
my Lord,
it's zero.
Yes.
It profit nothing.
That's right.
Amen.
You got to have love.
That's right. Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Paul, having corrected these problems, find himself tackling another problem.
Uh-huh.
Amen. The problem that he tackles today in our text is that the Corinthians did not believe in the resurrection. Amen. Not that they didn't believe, amen, that Jesus had got up. They didn't believe that his believers,
yes,
the followers,
yes, yes,
would get up.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
The problem we have today, they say it's impossible for someone to rise from the dead. From the very beginning, amen, the council, the scribes and the priests and all of them plotted and lied. Told the soldiers to lie.
My Lord.
Said that his disciples came and stole him away.
My Lord.
And we know that the disciples Amen. Was hiding behind closed doors.
Yes, yes, yes.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. It was in fear for their life. There's no way they was thinking about coming and steal a body.
Uh-huh.
Amen. If you go to with me to Matthew's 28. Amen. We see here in Matthew's 28. Amen. That the scribe and the council and all of them, amen, telling the disciples, tell them that the disciples stole the body. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
We see here that the angel came and blew the stone away.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen. And when they blew the stone away, the guards were so scared,
yeah,
they became at dead men's in 28:4.
Yes, yes.
Amen. And we see that the women's, amen, are crying and they want to know what they did with Jesus' body.
My Lord, my Lord.
And then we hear the angels come to Mary and the other women and they said, be not afraid, verse 5, for I know that you see Jesus who was crucified.
Yes.
He is not here,
for
he is risen as he said.
Yes.
My Lord.
Then they said, come and see the place where he lay.
Yes.
Amen. And then he told them, say, go quickly.
Yes.
Quickly.
Yes.
Amen. And tell the disciples to meet me in Galilee. Amen. That's where Jesus told him to meet him.
Yes.
In Galilee.
Yes.
The Corinthian Christians were not denying that Jesus was resurrected from the dead.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Paul had already established that. But again, they was denying our resurrection.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Amen. That the believer will never rise from the dead. Amen. And we see this in verse 12 in our text. It says, now if Christ is preached that he has been raised from the dead.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Hallelujah. In other words, they had already accepted that he had was risen from the dead.
Yeah.
Then he said, how do some among you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? Amen. We come to tell you, if God got up, if Jesus got up, we also one day will get up. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
He said, hallelujah. He's coming back to receive us to his own. Amen. Amen. They was influenced, amen, by Greek philosophers. Amen. Hallelujah. We got to be careful who we have company with.
All right.
Huh?
All right.
We have to be careful who we're listening to.
Amen.
Amen. They was influenced by the Sadducees. Amen. We know that they did not believe in the resurrection. Be mindful who you listen to.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. Do not be deceived. Evil communication, the Bible say, corrupt good habits.
That's right.
My Lord.
Amen. So don't, hey, man, don't go around them. I don't care how good they are.
Uh-huh.
Amen. How eloquent they speak.
Come on now.
Amen. If they're not speaking the right thing,
Come on.
Amen, you need to move on.
All right.
Hallelujah. Ooh. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. In verse 13 in our text, but if there is no resurrection of the dead,
yes,
it says then Christ is not risen.
That's right.
And if Christ is not risen, then our preaching is empty.
Yes.
Your faith is also empty.
Yeah.
If there is no resurrection. Amen. I hear Paul say, why do I put my life in danger every day?
Yeah.
Amen. It seems like when you tell, it's all right to tell a lie. Amen. They ain't gonna turn no head.
Come on now. Come on.
But if you tell the truth, you're going to be ridiculed. Amen. Talk about show is your bone. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
He said, why do I put my life in danger every day if there is no resurrection of the dead? He said, in Ephesus, I fought with beasts. Not animals, but men who was enemy of the gospel. Amen. Who threatened my life time and time again. Why have I put my life in so much danger defining the gospel if the dead do not rise? Man understand come from their senses. Can I get a witness? They come from their five senses. If he can't see it,
all right now.
He don't believe it.
Say that now.
Can I get a witness?
Say that.
If he can't hear it, smell it, taste it, or touch it,
my Lord.
Amen. He refused to believe it.
My Lord.
But I come to tell you what impossible with man.
Say that now.
Hallelujah.
Say that.
Hallelujah. Impossible with God.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen. Paul tells us in verse 3 of this chapter, in this text, that Christ died for our sins, according to the scriptures. And then Isaiah 53:5 tells us he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement for our peace was upon him. And by his stripes, we are healed.
Thank you, Lord.
Can I get a witness?
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. He is alive by many infallible proof.
Yes.
Amen. And we hear Luke telling this story.
Yes.
Amen. The physician, the doctor, Luke, amen, said that he is alive by many infallible proof.
Yes.
Amen. He wrote to one Theophilus in Acts, the first chapter, and he tells him, the first book I wrote to you, amen, is the beginning of Jesus' ministry.
Yeah.
Amen. But this book, this second book I write,
which
is Acts, hallelujah, it is the continuation of his ministry.
Amen.
He is alive by many infallible proofs.
Yeah.
Amen. And when we look at verse 5 in this text, of Corinthians, it said he was seen by Cephas.
That's right.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Then by the 12. And after that, he was seen by over 500 brothers at one time.
That's right.
He said after that, he was seen by his brother, James.
Yes.
Amen. Then he was seen also by the apostles.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Hallelujah. He is alive today.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
By many infallible proof.
Yes.
As we see Luke say, O Theophilus, Jesus is alive.
Yes.
Amen. By many infallible proof.
Yes.
He said he would be seen by over for 40 days. Mm-hmm. Amen. Teaching. Amen, about the kingdom of God.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And in our text, it says, verse 16, it says, for if the dead do not rise, then Christ is not risen. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And if Christ is not risen, your faith is futile.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. It's nothing to it. You are still in your sin.
My Lord.
And I'm so glad that I'm not in my sin.
Amen.
Because Christ died for me.
Amen.
And I want to say thank you, Lord,
Amen.
For saving me.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Ain't God good?
Yes.
He's alive.
Yes.
Amen. I know he's alive.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah. And I come to tell you, if you go around the world, amen, and you go to China, and you ask them where Buddha lay,
come on now.
Amen, I believe you will find his remains there.
All right.
Amen, if you go to see Muhammad, amen, you of town. Amen. And ask them that in the name of my Savior. Amen. I declare, amen, you'll find an empty tomb. Amen. Can I get a witness? Because he is not there. Can I get a witness? Amen. The women's wait to the grave. The night Jesus anointed Jesus' body. Amen. But they find the stone roll away. Amen. They begin to get nervous. Hallelujah. Amen. Thinking that somebody has stole the body. Amen. But the angel said, do not be afraid. Amen. For hallelujah, he's risen as he said. Amen. Go and tell my disciples to meet me in Galilee. Amen. There Jesus prepared them. Amen. Teaching them what they must do. Can I get a witness? Amen. Can I get one witness? Ain't God good? Amen. He's good, y'all. Hallelujah. And mercy endureth forever. Can I get a witness? After 40 days, amen, they said gravitation began to release his body. Can I get a witness? Amen. And he began to ascend into heaven. Amen. As he was ascending up in glory, the disciples standing there, amen, looking up in the sky. Amen. Can I get a witness? Amen. Not just the 12, but 500. Amen. Men's looking up. Amen. To see where Jesus was going. Hallelujah. But he was lifted up out of their sight. Can I get a witness? Amen. And as he got close to heaven doors, amen, I hear the psalmist say, lift up your head, all you gates, and be lifted up, ye everlasting doors, for the King of glory shall come in. And I hear him say, who is the King of glory? He said, the Lord, strong and mighty, he is the King. Hallelujah, of glory. Hallelujah, open up. Hallelujah, heaven doors and let it come in. Can I get a witness? It was one angel at the door, didn't recognize who Jesus was. He had been through 42 generations. Amen. He did not recognize him. Amen. They whipped him all night long. Amen. Till the flesh fell from his bone. Amen. He was unrecognizable. Amen. He put thorns on his head. Amen. And he twisted the thorns on his head. Amen. And the blood came trickling down. Amen. His face, when he got to the door, they said, who is this King of glory? They said, the Lord, strong and mighty. Amen. He is the King of glory. Amen. Lift up your everlasting doors and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King? The Lord is host. The Lord strong and mighty. He is the King. I come to tell you he's alive. Do you believe he's alive? Amen. Hallelujah. The disciples still looking up. Amen. I suppose they won't stay there forever. Look it up until the angel came. The angel came and stood by him and said, men of Galilee, why are you looking up in the sky? Amen. The same way he went up is the same way he's going to come down. Amen. And one day, amen, he's coming back for me. Amen. I thank you, Lord. Amen, for saving me. I was a wretch undone. Hallelujah. Wasn't fit to live. Hallelujah. It wasn't worthy to die. Amen. But the Lord came. Hallelujah. And he lifted me. Hallelujah. His love lifted me. Hallelujah. When nothing else could help, it was love that lifted me. Amen. I come to tell you that he is. He is alive by many infallible proof. Can I get a witness? God is alive. Amen. Yeah, hallelujah. You ask me how do I know that? Yes. Amen. I feel it.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Sometimes.
Yeah, Lord.
Do you ever feel him?
Yes.
Amen. I feel him in my hand.
Yes.
I feel him in my feet.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The songwriter said, I feel him all over me.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen.
Yes.
He's alive today.
Yes.
Amen. I wouldn't serve a dead Jew.
Come on now.
Amen. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Paul said, if he dead, amen, then our witness is futile.
My Lord.
Amen. We just going through the motion. Amen. It don't mean anything. But I believe he is alive. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Do you believe it today? Amen. There is no greater love than a man will lay down his life for a friend. Amen.
Amen.
If we could just sing that a little bit of it. There is no greater love. Amen. I believe it's in B flat. They always say I sing it too low. And there is, somebody sing that for me.